Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to welcome you to the beautiful Madinat Theatre for our fourth edition of Rotary's annual Concert for a Cause under the patronage of His Highness Sheikh Ahmed bin Saeed Al Maktoum and in the presence of a number of UAE and international guests. Sayyidati Sadati, نرحب بكم في مسرح مدينة الجميرة للاحتفال من خلال حفل موسيقي بعيد ميلاد كمان استراديفاريوس واسمه البازيني ويبلغ عمره 300 سنة ويتم هذا الحفل الموسيقي تحت رعاية سمو الشيخ أحمد بن سعيد المكتوم وفي حضور عدد من الشخصيات الإماراتية والعالمية والبالأخص الإيطالية ومن ضمن الشخصيات الإماراتية السيد محمد أحمد المر وهو كاتب لقصص قصيرة وهو كذلك رئيس مجلس الوطني ومن ضمن الشخصيات الإيطالية نشكر حضور القنصل العام الإيطالي وزوجته والسيدة نبيلة كريم الديبيتي كونسل لمصر. I'm trying to do it both in Arabic and I'll try some Italian maybe. Quindi passiamo all'italiano e ringraziamo per la loro presenza il console generale italiano e la sua moglie e l'Italian Trade Commissioner, non saprei come si dice in italiano, per la loro presenza. Grazie mille di essere qua con noi. For those who missed the Arabic part, Mr. Mohammed Ahmed Al-Mur is a leading UAE writer and he was elected with the majority votes of the 40 members as the Speaker of the 15th Legislative Chapter of the House for 4 years within the Federal National Council. That's the equivalent of what we would call the UAE Parliament. So maybe we could applaud his presence. And he's in good company because he is surrounded by the Italians, with the Italian Trade Commissioner and the Consul General and his wife, as well as the Consul, Deputy Consul General of Egypt. I'm having some problems with Egypt tonight. I apologize for that. I would like to mention to you that this unique concert in Dubai, because it's going to be a one night only in Dubai, is in support of Senses, which is a residential and daycare center for children with special needs. And we have people from Senses amongst us, representing the founder of Senses, Mrs. Khawla, and Dr. Lina, who's the heart and soul of Senses, taking care of all the children. Thank you for your presence. This concert will witness the brilliance of Antonio Stradivari's violin-making talent centuries after his passing away. As I said, this is a 300-year-old violin called the Bazzini. The Bazzini was made in 1715 during Stradivari's golden period, and we will have this real privilege of celebrating with its violinist its 300th anniversary here in Madinat Theatre. To introduce the artists, Matteo Fedeli, for those who don't know him, is also known as the man of the Stradivari. He has played 25 of the only 50 remaining Stradivaris in the world. Since 2005, Maestro Fedeli is pursuing a project which is known as a Stradivari for the people, to make known to everybody the unique sound of the musical instruments of the famous Antonio Stradivari. And we have actually noticed that not many people in the UAE knew exactly what a Stradivarius was. I'm supposing that because you're all here, you certainly know what a Stradivarius is. Matteo has performed in more than 600 concerts, carrying his music to over 400,000 people around the world, and has gone on the most prestigious stages in the world, including the Assembly Hall of the United Nations in Geneva, the Severance Hall in Cleveland, the Duomo of Milan, and the Ponchielli Teatro in Cremona, where for the first time in the world, he has actually paid four Stradivarius on the same occasion. During his long career, although he's very young, he has dedicated many events to charity, and Matteo is giving us his talent and time graciously in support of Senses tonight. That you would maybe be impressed about. I was very impressed when I discovered it. He played for Pope Benedict the 16th. That's quite an achievement. And the violin, which was blessed by the Pope, sold three times its value, which is then again quite an investment for the person who bought it. Matteo will be accompanied at the piano by Maestro Andrea Carcano, an equally brilliant and talented musician who will be offering us as well a solo performance later on. Andrea Carcano, born in Milan, a pupil of Bruno Canino, has played repeatedly in Switzerland, France, Austria, the Czech Republic, Germany, and now for the first time in Dubai. He has performed several solo performances, Bach's Goldberg variations, but also lesser known authors such as Alkan, Ridger, and Janet. Andrea has collaborated with groups such as the soloists of La Scala, the Trio of Italian Needs, Antwerp, musicians at La Scala, and he's a teacher of piano since 1995, and currently a full professor of the Music Conservatory Vivaldi in Alessandria. Okay. We would like to extend as well a heartfelt thanks to those without whom the organization of this event would not have been possible. Emirates Airlines, who has offered the tickets for the crew, for the artist and his crew. Thank you very much. Al Habtour Group, who offered the lodging for the artist and the crew. Yamaha & Thompson, who offered the grand piano here, which is going to be played by Andrea Carcano. Tonight's program, if you haven't received it, starts with Sergei Rachmaninoff, Danse Hongroise, opus 6, numéro 2. Gabriel Fauré, Après un rêve. Camille Saint-Saëns, Danse Macabre, opus 40. And then there will be a solo performance by Andrea Carcano. And then we should have César Franck, Sonata in La Maggiore. And then Paganini with Cantabile, to finish with Béla Bartók, Danze Rumene e Sei Danze Popolari. Matteo and Andrea, the stage is yours.
Thank you. Pleasure for us to be here and play for you this wonderful violin. For us is the first time in this place, wonderful place, and we are happy for this. The first piece that we played was by Rachmaninoff, an Hungarian dance, and now we play by Gabriel Fauré, a French composer, A Present Rêve, After a Dream.
Thank you.
I need for my little English some note, okay, like something about the music, if I found, okay. The next piece of music is by Johannes Brahms. The FAE Sonata is this the name for the name of the notes. Is a work for violin and piano, and it's a collaborative musical work by three composers. Robert Schumann, his pupil Albert Dietrich, and a young Johannes Brahms. This sonata was Schumann's ideas in a gift tribute to violinist, German violinist, Joseph Joachim, and wrote in October 1853. We play the Scherzo by Brahms.
Thank you.
Now we play the piece was born with the name of Chanson, a melody for voice and piano. But this is a symphonic poem, the continuous of program music of Baroque period. As you know, the four seasons of Antonio Vivaldi were the first example of this music. Here, the instruments imitate the sound of nature, the storm in the summer, the animal, you think to the sound of bird who sing the spring, or the raindrops through the pizzicato violins. Saint-Saëns, for his composition, inspired himself to the song of Henri Casali. These the words. We are in front of a church and it's midnight. The bell ringed 12 times. Then you can hear the footsteps from the nearby cemetery. The full moon lies to the branches of the trees, a ghostly figure. It's a skeleton. He walks and brings in his hand a violin. The violin is out of tune because it was in a grave for a long time, and the skeleton calls the ghost and spirit through its sound. This is a normal tune, and this is the skeleton violin. Saint-Saëns takes these notes for the theme of his melody. G, A flat, A natural, B flat, B natural, C. And then makes the theme of the dance. This melody surrounds someone and something. The ghosts and spirits run up and down and start to dancing, a crazy dance. Wind, screams and fear reign in the cemetery for all night. But the sunrise came and the sing of the cock was announcing a new day. Now, a strong percussion of the piano, and soon the ghost spirits go away. The skeleton plays for the last time the melody, and the piece end with two pizzicato. Thank you.
Thank you.
We are about in the middle of our concert, and this project was born 10 years ago. I had the occasion to play my first Stradivarius. I was young. I met one of the last violin built by Antonio Stradivari. It was an instrument built in 1731. And a young musician who met an old violin with all the experience of the great masterpiece of Cremona. We play for this project in Italy before, in all the places, auditorium, castles, churches, and all the space, schools, and hospitals also. And then, from 5 years, we spread our music and the culture of Italian country in the world with many concerts also in the United States. And it's a pleasure for me and the honor to have the opportunity to play this wonderful instrument. I played 25 instruments by Stradivarius, and for 50 years of the great masterpiece, I know Antonio Stradivari through his instruments. Every Stradivari has a name, a nickname, because violinist, musicians, or many families had this instrument. King, knight, every people. And then is an history very, very interesting for me, and I try to tell with the music to you. And now, we have I ask to Andrea to play something and a solo for a piano, proprio in the middle of our concert. And then io chiamo Andrea, I tell the name of Andrea, and he can explain the piece of music.
Good evening. I think is in this program we can listen to music, violin music by the king of the violin, Stradivari. And so I think for this intermission with the solo piano, there is not a king of the piano, because the piano is a young instrument in front of violin. And so, but there is maybe a king of the piano composer. And I think it's Franz Liszt. I want to play the Hungarian Rhapsody, number 14.
Thank you.
Sonata of Franck, we play the Allegro. Paganini was a first violin of Elisa Bacciocchi Court Orchestra in Lucca, Italy. She was the sister of Napoleon Bonaparte. We are in the early years of 19th century. Paganini plays, directs the orchestra, and writes music. In this year, he makes wonderful piece of Cantabile. Other composers wrote music for singers, soprano, contralto, tenore, and basso. But Paganini gave to the violin the colors of human voice. Cantabile. Thank you. our concert of the program. I tell you something about the Stradivari, the Stradivari history. The first period of Stradivari is called Amatise, because his instruments were similar to his teacher Amati's form. At the end of the 17th century, Stradivari built the violins lunghetto. This name because the side was narrow and the body longer than other violins. The sound was beautiful, but the violins were not comfortable for the musicians. Stradivari came back to the first form, and in the early years of 18th century, he built the best violin. In 1710, begins his golden period in which combines the choice of wood, the perfect work, and the composition of his varnishes with the best acoustic sound. The violin that I use today is considered one of the best in the world and was created by the skilled hands of Antonio Stradivari during his golden period. His name is Bazzini and came from Antonio Bazzini, violinist, composer, and director of the conservatory in Milan. When he died in 1897, the violin passed through the hands of Jankovic, another violinist of a city, Trieste in Italy, and Albertina Ferrari, mother of a famous actor and director, Giorgio Strehler, and several private owners, including a wealthy Hungarian who lived in Rome too. He didn't know to play the violin, so he gave the instrument to the Italian violinist Gioconda De Vito. She brought it on the stage of the main theaters of the world. When he was 54, she performed for the last time before leaving at the age of her success. It was 1961. 3 years later, the violin was brought for a great exhibition of Stradivari on the Borromeo's Island in the major lake in Italy, but in this occasion didn't play. Since the 16th violin Bazzini, 1715, disappeared from the scene and public music life. I have this violin from about 1 year for play for my project. And the last piece of our concert are the Romanian Dance by Béla Bartók. Béla Bartók often walked in the Hungarian country and listened to the popular music who folk artists played. He kept this music and transported it into the classical language. Romanian Folk Dances is a suite of pieces composed by Béla Bartók in 1915. This is based on Romanian tunes from Transylvania. They are sick and connect one of each other. Their name are stick dance, sash dance, in one spot, dance from Buscum, Romania polka, and fast dance. You can listen to the version that the Hungarian violinist Albert Kocsis wrote for me. Thank you. Encore. Bis. We have a legend for the beast.
Thank you.
when I play my first Stradivari, there was a press release with a journalist, people who attended this, and I saw the violin into a glass case. I didn't play for the moment. I only see the violin. Then, little by little, people go away, the security and journalists go away, and I, along with the violin, in the case. And then I open and bring the violin. First, I saw the design of the instrument. I saw the varnish that remained in the table, the perfect word of Stradivari, the whole of F, the punte. This is a good word for the violin maker, and the back of the violin with the marezzatura is like a wave of the sea. This is a acero, the typical wood, but I see only the scroll. And then, for the last, I try to watch the level inside the violin. There is a little label with the name of the violin maker, with the name of Antonio Stradivari. And then, while I try to look this, a little voice from away said to me, "Who are you? What do you want to me? What do I do in your hands?" I was played by the master violinist in the century. And then show me, what do you do to able with me, with the sound? And I bring the bow and play a beautiful and sweet melody like this. have a little gift, and then I wish to thank for the organization of this concert, the Rotary Club, Rotary International, the president, past president, all people in the Rotary. My friends from Milano, Paolo Dutto, who introduced me with the Rotary Genera, and Geta, of course, for your work, and Emily. And then we are there for, we are here for a special occasion and for help the kids of senses. And I saw Dr. Lina. And, thank you, Lina. Please. I have a little gift for you. I have a CD with our music, and this is a little bridge, the bridge of wood, like this. I brought this from the table of my violin maker. And this is the same, but the only difference is that the violin maker works 5, 6, or 8 hours to make this for the violin. The bridge is the first piece of wood that receive the vibration of the string and spread around the body of the violin on the table, and through the sole, a little piece of wood, at all the instrument on the back. But I think the bridge is a sign for the friendly, for the culture without custom in the world, and also for the peace. Is a message this for you and for all the Geta and Emily. Yes, okay. For you.
So we would also like to offer something, and I would call our incoming president, Ghalib Farha, please, together with our current president, Amelie Zegmut Kamse, to give the small gifts we have, a token of Dubai. It was joking past, it's because we had a luncheon. And obviously we had our past president, Hussein Al-Jaziri, please. Can you say hi? Because, and we don't dare to say the word because it's PPP. And our past president, Ahmed Bil Sleh, and he's PP.
So, of course, after Matteo and Andrea's beautiful gift, it's very odd for me to offer our one. We're very, very honored, Maestro Matteo and Maestro Andrea, to have you here with us tonight. And I can only be thankful to all of you who's always respond with a big yes to the Rotary events, especially when it comes to supporting Senses, one of our major projects. So I'm sure you all enjoy the evening. I'm sure you have full of emotions, and you'll go back home with full of emotions. And again, Thank you so much, Matteo. Thank you so much, Andrea, for all your help, all your support. We really appreciate you actually went to Senses to spend some time with the children. This is not enough done. We tend to attend a lot of events, but I encourage all of you to attend Senses. Everybody knows Dr. Lina now. Please feel free to just cross the roads. There are 93 beautiful children that just ask to be hugged and to be loved and to be cared about. So please, anytime you can, pass by Senses and join us with Rotary to support such beautiful causes. A small gift of thanks. So this is, as you know, one of the landmarks of Dubai. It's also the landmark of our club, the Rotary Club of Jumeirah, which is Burj Arab. So thank you so much again.
Words. We were wondering which one to give to which, and thankfully we didn't need to think a lot because they've been working together for 12 years, so they won't fight about which one gets which.
Now we do the last gift for you. We have only. Now only a music for you. Before the last encore, I ask a picture with you in the middle of the stage, if possible. Also for the play. Also play together with me, if possible. Yes. You play with me in the stage, of course. Andrea, prego. Yes. You play, and then. Okay. With me, in the middle of the stage, with me. Please. I arrive very, very soon. We have only 1 minute of music for you. And this is a particular piece because the violin play many notes. I asked to Andrea to count how many notes I play. But how many notes, Andrea? Do you?
I don't know.
Okay. So we can try this. We play and you count the notes. You have 1 minute. The notes are about 750. I don't know. You can try and tell me after. Okay? The Fly of Bumblebee.